Good day, everyone. Dean Calhoun from Affygility Solutions here, and it's Monday, April 17th, 2017. And today I'm going to answer a question from one of our clients. The question is, in the context of potent compound safety, what is the difference between an occupational hazard category versus a control ban? Well, this is a very interesting question, and we get this question quite often from a number of clients and prospects. So I'd like to answer this question in two parts. The first part is by discussing what is an occupational health category. Well, an occupational health category is the assignment of a compound to a health hazard based on the inherent toxicology and properties of that compound. It's important to know that the occupational health category is based solely on the toxicology of the compound. And unless there is new toxicology data that indicates otherwise, the OHC does not change. I should mention that there is additional confusion added to this concept because often an occupational health category is called many different terms. These terms can include occupational health category, occupational exposure ban, occupational hazard category, but either way, it means the same thing. Now, one of the key concepts when dealing with occupational health categories is the higher the occupational health hazard, the higher the rating. I should mention there are many different occupational health category schemes. For example, in this chart, you see 9 different OHC schemes. Here at Affygility Solutions, on a weekly basis, we deal with 6 or 7 different schemes. And here in this slide, using the Affygility Solutions OHC scheme, you can see how we assigned an occupational health category to each of these compounds. For example, acetaminophen is a category 1. Fluoxetine hydrochloride is a category 2. Azathioprine is a category 3. And estradiol is a category 4. And finally, dihydroxy vitamin D3 is a category 5. Again, I need to stress, there are many different OHC schemes. So depending on the system or scheme that your company adopts, the OHC assignment may differ from what's shown on the screen. Now let's move on to the second part of the question. What is control banding? Well, the definition of control banding I like to use is the one that is presented in an article by Dr. Bruce Nauman with Merck & Company. In this article, Dr. Nauman indicated that control banding is a process of assigning a compound to a hazard category that corresponds to a range of airborne concentrations and the engineering controls, administrative controls, and personal protective equipment needed to ensure safe handling. So it's very important to remember that control banding is all about controls. It's not about the toxicology directly. So there's the two parts to our answer. Now, let's by example show how they relate. In a perfect world, an occupational health category would directly match up to the same control ban. So an OHC 1 compound would require control ban 1 controls, and an OHC 5 compound would require control ban 5 controls. But the problem with that direct approach, it doesn't take into consideration the quantity, the duration of the activity, the physical form, and other factors that influence exposure potential. In other words, it doesn't take into consideration the exposure potential or the risk of the activity. This is where risk assessments come in. Risk assessments are the link between the occupational health category and the control. So I hope that answers your question. Finally, I'd like to end by saying here at Affygility Solutions, we have developed hundreds of occupational exposure limits and acceptable daily exposure monographs for active pharmaceutical ingredients. These monographs are developed by expert toxicologists with advanced degrees, professional certifications, and decades of pharmaceutical industry experience. Through our online service called OEL Fast Track, we have made available these OEL monographs for purchase, and they can be instantly downloaded. Check it out by going to OELFastTrack.com. And if you'd like more information regarding occupational exposure limits or ADEs for active pharmaceutical ingredients, you can contact us through any of the sources you see on the screen. Thank you and have a great day.